Today's topic is vaginal discharge. So, before starting the pathologies in the vagina, first we will discuss the normal defense mechanism of vagina. So, there is opposition of vulva which protects the entry of organisms. The apocrine gland secretion is rich in undeclinic acid and this is antifungal. And opposition of anti and posterior vaginal walls, they are always in unison, and mature, well-developed stratified squamous epithelium of vagina helps to ward off any infections. The vaginal pH is very acidic, that is 4.5, because of the lactic acid which is produced from glycogen in epithelial cells by duodenal bacilli. And there is also the cervical mucus, which is bacteriolytic. The endometrium sheds periodically, which tends to eliminate any infection. And the tube ciliary movement towards the uterus also prevents ascending infection in the fallopian tubes. Now, it is a very difficult syndrome. So, it can be vaginitis or cervicitis. So, cervicitis, the common causes are Neisseria gonorrhoeae and Chlamydia trachomatis. And vaginitis, the common causes include the Trichomonas vaginitis, Candida albicans and bacterial vaginosis. So, effective management of cervicitis is more important from patient point of view, because cervicitis can ascend up and cause the pelvic inflammatory disease. So, vaginal discharge is not an adequate indicator of any particular sexually transmitted disease, and it makes it a poor algorithm entry point. So, in the algorithm of the syndromic management of WHO. So, we have used risk assessment, and this helps to improve the performance of syndromic management algorithms, and the probability that correct treatment of STI will relative to the probability of over-treatment is increased. So, we should not make sure that we are doing syndromic management in all the cases. Whereas in vaginal discharge, it is more important to do the correct treatment than the syndromic treatment. So, what are the risk factors for vaginal discharge? Age less than 21, multiple partners, male partner having urethral discharge, new partner in past 3 months, and a single patient with a high risk behavior. So, first coming to the infections of the vagina, we can have bacterial vaginosis, vulvovaginal candidiasis, or vaginal trichomoniasis. So, vaginal environment is a dynamic ecosystem, and it contains lot of colony forming units, and normal vaginal discharge is clear to white, odorless, and highly viscous. Normal bacterial flora is dominated by lactobacilli, and which dominates over all other bacilli. And lactic acid helps to maintain a vaginal pH of 3.2 to 4.2. And the acidic environment of the vagina and other host immune factors inhibit the overgrowth of any bacteria, and lactobacilli also produce hydrogen peroxide. Now, vaginitis or the infection of vagina is characterized by discharge, itching, irritation, and odor. The commonest variety is the vaginosis variety, vulvovaginal candidiasis and trichomonas. Now, there is a difference between the term itis and osis, because some people say that they are normally found microorganisms inside the vagina. So, it is not actually an infection. It is just a cohabitation. So, that is why some people like to use the term vaginosis, and presence of bacteria other than the lactobacilli is called as vaginosis. So, other cause of vaginitis can be just allergic reaction to some cosmetics, herpes simplex, mucopurulent cervicitis, atrophic vaginitis of senility, vulval vestibulitis, foreign bodies in vagina like pessary or a toy, and desquamative inflammatory vaginitis. Now, how to diagnose? First, we have to take the patient history, do a per-speculum examination, and look at the appearance of the discharge. Now, how to prepare the specimen? The vaginal discharge has to be collected and put on a glass slide, and then put a drop of sodium chloride or put a drop of KOH. Then it is called as wet mount in sodium chloride or wet mount in KOH. Another way to add the KOH and smell the whiff, that is called as a whiff test. And another test done on the discharge is to check for the pH of the discharge. Now, when we put sodium chloride and put the objective at 40 times magnification, we can see some desquamated vaginal cells in the vaginal discharge. So, we can see some blood cells, pus cells, or polymorphonucleocytes. If the patient has intercourse the day before, we can also see the sperms, and we can see a squamous epithelial cells. These are the normals normal vaginal smear. Now suppose if we see a smear like this, which has got a vaginal cell which is studded with small coma shaped or round bacilli. This is with a cell, vaginal cell with crenated margin because of the studded microorganisms. This is called as a clue cell. Now this again is a clue cell which is seen after staining and gram staining has been done, and we see these are the small coma shaped or round bacilli and they are not rod shaped. The normal bacilli in vagina is lactobacilli, which is rod shaped, but here we are seeing a vaginal cell which is heavily studded with a round and coma shaped organism. So this is called as a clue cell and this is very pathognomic of Amsel's criteria of bacterial vaginosis. Coming to the normal, how does it look like, how lactobacilli look like under a hanging drop? So these are the 40 times objective magnification, and the lactobacilli is a rod shaped bacteria, and here we are seeing that this is not a clue cell, whereas these are normal epithelial vaginal cells. So this is the lactobacilli surrounding the normal vaginal cell. Now some other tests are there, like the culture of the vaginal discharge, DNA probing of the vaginal discharge, rapid test, nucleic acid amplification test, PIP activity, BV blue test, and the PCR assay.